I think because what is important in the icon is not only the face of Christ or of Virgin Mary or of the saints, but the light beyond. The important attitude is to remind us that we are in the presence of God and to start to speak with Him also silently, not just by words. And this communion of our mind with God, it's the beginning of a good prayer, although we are in the cities or we are working in the office. And it's a question of desire to meet God and to let God share in our life. The prayer is not only our activity, it's the activity of God in us, and especially when we see around us many people suffering. We feel the duty to become more and more the hands of Christ, helping those who need our help, and to discover the icon of Christ in the suffering of our fellow humans.
Back in the city, a recurring question lingers in our minds. How can we translate the peace of these monastics to the busyness of our modern lives? Soon after, we have the unexpected grace of an audience with the Patriarch of all Romania, His Beatitude Theoctist.
It's a rare moment. To meet someone with such great power and holiness, it's like meeting with a pope.
Soon after our meeting, he was to pass away in the Lord, and Archbishop Daniil succeeded to his place.
Și zic, mulți dintre semenii noștri, nu pot să cred, nu pot să mă rog. Bătrânul părinte, când i-a spus tânărul, că la ce folosește rugăciunea? Că mă rog și parcă nu mă rog, nu simt foloasele ei. Bătrânul atunci i-a spus fratelui tânăr să ia un ciur, un coș de nuiele făcute din smicele și să-i aducă apă. Și venea, scotea și ciurul mai ia o dată și mai ia o dată și tot așa. Privește la coș, este același coș ca înainte de a-l băga în apă. Coșul era rat, strălucea. Ei, vezi puterea rugăciunii.
So this is the power of prayer. It cleans.
Da.
As monasticism spread from the Mediterranean countries, it moved north to the Slavic lands, Ukraine and Russia.
Это, собственно, постоянная молитва. Вне молитвы монах уже монахом не является. Вне молитвы это монах не молящийся, это просто человек, носящий черные одежды. Молитва, и в частности Иисусова молитва, которая является основным деланием монаха, это делание, которое передается по наследству, передается от старца к ученику. И, к сожалению, в советское время эта преемственность была утрачена. Да, я пришел в монастырь перед самым развалом Советского Союза. Но вот в те времена, когда советская власть была в силе, естественно, между словом «монах» и между словом «мученик» можно было ставить знак равенства.
Преподобные отцы наши Зверинецкие, молите Бога о нас.
This cave named Погребальная. A lot of monks' graves are there. You see some relics. It's relics of monks 11th, 12th century. They know only one or two prayers. One of those prayers was «Господи Иисусе Христе, Сыне Божий, помилуй меня грешного, в простоте глубина». And these easy words, very big deepness. Mm-hmm. This is Kyiv church named Arkhangel Mikhail, St. Michael. Two place for sitting. Ancient monk prayers some 4, 5, or even 10 hours. It's very, very hard with their diseases to stay in this church, so they have some rest for their legs, but not for their mind and their hand.
It's only a short jaunt by air from Kyiv to Moscow.
We're on our way, heading for the main monastery of all Russia, Sergiev Posad.
We turn back now to speak to Father Jacob, one of the spiritual teachers and professor of Hebrew scripture at St. Sergei's Monastery.
One of the fathers said that prayer is the life of the soul, and yet today many people encounter Christianity almost as if there is no prayer within it. They need a formal aspect of Christianity.
You see that it's a tragedy with the Western world, because the multitude of people which are living here have lost this treasury of pure Christianity. That's why it became tradition. Jesus' prayer, this is not only tradition, but it's the core, the string of our monastic being from the very beginning of the life inside these walls, in ourselves, in our divine services, in our relations, in our words, in our even breathing of this air. The quietness of heart, the peace of heart, it's not the main idea or the main aim of this process of this praying. No, it's the foundation. We should realize that in the next hour I can die, but my heart, my feelings, my soul, my body, my brains belong to Christ. That's why I'm not afraid of this world, of temptations, of sorrows, of difficulties. No, our feeling is that you can die tomorrow. And that's why we are free in God. It's the very optimistic feeling.
The Jesus prayer initially was practiced in the caves. Now it can be practiced in the modern caves of people living in blocks, in apartments, in big cities, being busy, but having also reserved some private space in their hearts, in their minds for Jesus prayer. It's not the place where a person lives, it's the way the person lives which matters. It goes back to the saying of the scripture, to the above the commandment and the teaching of Jesus when he said that everyone who calls my name will be saved.
God is always present, and that's something that I'm always aware of. My relationship with God is in these words, Lord, have mercy on me, a sinner.
The Jesus prayer.
The Jesus prayer, yeah. That encompasses everything.
Господи, Иисусе Христе, Сыне Божий, помилуй меня грешного. Господи, Иисусе Христе, Сыне Божий, помилуй меня грешного. Господи 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 Иисусе Христе, Сыне Божий.